Hi everyone. Welcome back. So happy to be here with you again. Let's see. Yeah. So Arizona, Istanbul, Colorado, London. Lovely. Hi, Tai. And Maria, Germany. So welcome, everyone. So nice to see you. I hope you are doing well, and I hope everybody can hear me. Is the sound okay? And everybody can see me. Ah, Kirsty's mom and dad, lovely. So, yeah. Right, how are you all? So that is the question I would really like to start with, is to take a moment to tune in and see where you are, especially in your nervous system. I've been talking about the nervous system a lot the last while, and for good reason, because it's so helpful if we learn to read our nervous system and know what to do to shift from anxiety and stress and freeze, so from, you know, fight, flight, or freeze, back into the green zone where we are connected and we feel at ease and present and are able to even do our spiritual practice and are able to be receptive to that. So I'd like to just tune in to where we are. And then the practice today, what we're going to do is opening up the thoracic spine. So the upper spine, if you like. And that usually affects everything that's above and everything that's below. So then we also take with us the lower spine, and we of course affect the cervical, the more the neck. And you'll feel a lot better afterwards. And then of course, the last couple of minutes, we will sit together. Getting a lot more people here now. Super nice you're all here. And thank you for joining. All right, so let's check in for a moment. So take a comfortable seat and close your eyes. And take really a moment to allow the weight to drop. And then take a deep breath in, and with a little bit of a sound, a sigh, breathe out. Like that. An audible sound. So this stimulates the vagus nerve, and the vagus nerve has to do with the parasympathetic nervous system, the rest and digest nervous system. So it helps us to already come into that place of presence and ease. So inhale deeply. Okay, and then I'd like you to become still. Tune in and feel what's going on with you right now. So how is it going? Are you feeling relaxed? Are you feeling tense? Are you feeling anxious? And don't try and change anything right now, right here. What I'd like you to do is learn to read your nervous system, learn to acknowledge where you are without the need to change it. So you just bring mindfulness to the situation as it is. So how do you feel? Is your mind super busy? Is your body tight and tense? Or do you feel all relaxed and present today? So where do you think you are? Are you in the fight flight, in the red zone part of the nervous system? You're trying to get away from something or ready to take something on, but tight and a mobilizing part of our nervous system? Or are you more in the freeze part of your nervous system, where we try just we're feeling too overwhelmed with everything that's going on, and we're trying to not feel, and we disappear somewhat. And the freeze can feel pretty relaxed in a way, but you are numb. You don't feel so much, so it's not where we want to be. Or do you feel alive and joyful and present? Are you in the green zone? And this is not about good or bad. This is about learning to assess where you are so that you can learn to take steps to where you want to be. And also please remember that healing and bringing yourself back to balance, your body and your mind, will only ever happen when you are in the green zone, when you are relaxed. This is when the healing mechanisms of the body are being activated. When we are in the red zone or in the blue zone, the freeze, we're not healing. So it's okay to be in freeze or fight or flight. You just need to be able to recognize it and always find ways to come back to green so that you give the body plenty of opportunity and the mind to restore and to recharge and to heal, because that only happens in green. Okay. So once you kind of have an idea of where you are, you can come back now and inhale and open your eyes. Wonderful. Take another deep breath in. And exhale. Okay. And then we're going to stand up and start to open up our upper body a little bit. So we're moving a little bit through the three zones of the body that get tight: the upper body, the mid body, and the lower body. So we start with the upper body. I'm going to move this that way. Yes, pretty good. So you don't have to see my feet for now. So stand up, and we start to feel our feet. We start to ground to our feet. And as you release the weight into the floor, you feel a natural lift up through the spine. Let that happen. And release the neck a little bit. And then begin to, I think my dog is, come on then. You can begin to roll your shoulders high. Roll your shoulders around to warm up the shoulders. Keep going. And roll them the other direction. And close your eyes and actually feel the warmth of the movement both ways. And if this feels good, we can sort of swing the arms in a figure of eight in front of us. So it's a lying figure of eight, a horizontal figure of eight. And you can let the hips and the legs sort of help that movement. Nice. And see if you can turn the figure of eight around, which is actually maybe a little harder than you think. Okay. And then we get a little bit into the thoracic spine. First, actually more shoulders. Just take your arms out. You rotate one arm in and one arm back. So it's the other way around. So let's move the right arm in and the left arm back. And then change. So it's internal rotation and external rotation with the different arms. And then go a little quicker. It's a lovely way to mobilize around the shoulders and the upper body. And then you're going to bring the right arm in internal rotation, hold it. So it's the back of the hand that faces forward almost, and the top of the hand begins to face up. Place your other hand behind your head. And then we're going to turn towards the extended arm. So you're just going to turn the body and draw the shoulders in as you turn. So it's a thoracic rotation. We do that a few times so you can come back and turn. And also till this feels warm and open. It's quite a nice move if you work at a computer a lot. Okay, right. And then turn the other arm that way. So you rotate The left arm now, the palm facing away from you and towards up, right hand behind your head. You turn towards that extended arm with your upper body and your elbow. And you feel movement in the upper spine. And a few times again to feel quite tired and there's energy getting in there. You can also bring your breath into it. Inhale, exhale if you like. Inhale, open, exhale, turn. Okay, and release. And then take a moment to just feel. So close your eyes and feel the life, the experience of life and fluids and energy and circulation in the neck and shoulders and upper spine. And then begin to gently bounce as we do. And also take your hands with you and deep breath in. And exhale. Oh, okay. Shake it out. And again, feel. Tune into the experience of your body. We know we have a body. Now, if you close your eyes, how do you know you have a body? What is the experience of your body? It can be subtle. It can be stronger with sensation. It can be subtle feeling lots of energy moving through the body and circulation and sort of the subtle movement of cells. Wonderful. And then inhale, you can take your arms up. And exhale, gently come into a forward bend, bending the knees all the way down for a moment. Let your head hang and shake it out. Place your hands on your shin bones. Inhale, open the chest forward, lengthen the spine, and exhale, fold back in. Okay, one more time. Inhale, open forward, and then exhale, place your hands on the floor and step back into a downward dog pose. Great. And in the downward dog pose, and for a few times, just bend and straighten the legs. To get a little bit more into the thoracic, come in onto the toes and shift the heels over to the right. So feel the side body and also a little bit the upper spine and to the left. One more time, inhale to the right, exhale, inhale to center and exhale to the left. And then come onto all fours. So is this clear? I think so. I'll just turn this down a little bit. Hi. So wonderful. And then being on all fours, we're just going to keep moving with the thoracic spine. So I'd like you to place one hand on your heart, take your right hand on your heart, and just sort of bring your elbow up. Inhale, lift your heart, and exhale, turn towards the left. And we do that again. Inhale, open, and exhale to the left. I'm putting my hand on my shoulder because the microphone is in the way. Open and turn to the left. And now place your hand behind your head. Inhale, open to the side. And exhale, turn to the left. And again, inhale, press into your left hand. Open to the right. Exhale, turning to the left. Now take your whole hand, arm up. Straighten it. Open it up. We're more used to this. And exhale, twist underneath, shoulder moving towards the floor. Inhale, press and open. And exhale, arm through towards the floor. Last one. Wonderful. Hold and down. And then come back to center. And then we do this on the other side. So first of all, your hand on your heart. And inhale, take your elbow up. Look up. And exhale, turn towards the right. Inhale, elbow up, look up. And exhale to the right. One more time, up and exhale. And then place your hand behind your head. Inhale, coming up a little more, open it up and exhale, turning it in. One more time and in. And then take your whole arm up. So inhale, sweep your whole left arm up, keep it more or less straight and thread it through side of the head, shoulder towards the floor. Inhale, coming up again and through. And up again. This time, hold for a moment. Hold. And through. And come back on all fours. And take a moment to sit on your heels. And once more, feel into your body. Slightly draw your head back in space. You might want to do that wiggling your head back in space a little bit. Placing your left hand to the side and taking your right arm up. Inhale, exhale, a little bit of a side bend. And then you open, twisting open a little to the back as well. And exhale a little back to the front. So just moving your arm diagonally to the back and also exhale diagonally to the left arm. One more time. And sweeping along the floor to the other side, left arm to the side and exhale to the back. Towards the right arm. So you're sort of diagonally drawing the left arm from forward towards the right arm and back. Diagonally over the left. And feel these movements still also in the upper body. One more time. And come back to center. And once more, feel. So this part of the body should be beginning to feel quite open and alive mostly. And then come into a lunge. So you can step your right foot forward. It's not easy actually to do the only on camera work. Good. And in the lunge, you can twist towards the open side. So if your left leg is face me and twist towards the open side and take your arm out. And then you take your arm up again, so a little bit side body stretch, and then you thread it underneath the left arm. And we do that a few times. Inhale, forearm can be on the thigh, and exhale, thread it through. Inhale, take your arm up, and exhale, thread it through. And this time, tuck your back toes under. As you come up, push your back knee up, take your heel to the floor, and come into a side angle pose. So this takes stability in the lower body. So really focus on the lower body stable. So your tension stays in the lower body, even though your upper body keeps making the movement. So exhale, turn back to your toes, knee back to the floor, gentle landing, turning the arm underneath the leg again. And inhale, come back to that side angle pose. Two more times. Exhale, down, inhale, up. And then we stay up. We take our arm up and over. So we're in a nice sideward bend. Breathe here, inhale. And exhale, bring both hands and knees back to the floor and change side now. So now you're stepping your other foot forward. Come up into your lunge. Forearm on the thigh. Turn to the open side. So left arm is out now. And then we're going to inhale, take that arm up. And exhale, thread it underneath the right leg. Inhale, take your arm up to the side. Feel a stretch along the whole side body. And exhale, twisting the arm underneath the leg. Up and twist. Now tuck your back toes under, prepare. Inhale, side angle. So onto the heel, take that arm up. Exhale, turn back. Steady in the lower body, arm threads underneath. Inhale, slowly turn, back heel down, open it up. Exhale, back. So this is also a good challenge for your strength and balance, which needs you to be present. So we're really challenging our green zone of being connected to our body and present. Okay, then you take your left arm over. Feel the stretch along the whole left side. Inhale here. And exhale back down. Step your right leg back into a downward dog for a moment. Walk it out. Deep breath in. And exhale, knees back to the floor. And we finish with a twist that also involves the hips a lot. So if you come and lie on the back, this is a really nice favorite twist of mine. And we're going to start with the right leg. And you're going to take the leg over to the left. Actually, before you take the leg over, let's move the left leg over to the right a little bit. So the left leg already moves over to the right. And then you take the right knee over to the side. And you don't have to go very far down. My knee is not even close to the floor. You don't need to have that. You bend your back knee and see if you can hold your foot with the back hand. And if not, you could maybe use a belt or just moving towards holding the foot. And you can be staying here. Or you could also begin to straighten the front leg and maybe even hold your foot. So I'm in a binded twist right now. I'm holding both feet. You don't need to do that. And it's really quite a lovely feeling. And then you can scoot your hips back over to the right a bit. That's what I'd like to do. And turn my head over to the right as well. Breathe. And gently release back out to center. And then we take this to the other side. So you extend your right leg, left knee to your chest. Scoot your right leg over to the left a little bit. And then support your left leg over to the right. And again, it doesn't need to go to the floor. I'm scooting my hips a little over to the left so I can roll more on the side of the hip. And then bending the bottom leg and holding that foot with my left hand. And if you wish, you can also extend your front leg, the top leg, and hold that with your hand. Of course, your foot can be on the floor, but it doesn't have to be. And then turn your head towards the left if that feels good. And take a few breaths here. So this is a twist, a quad stretch, stretch in the upper thigh, as you can feel, and also a hamstring stretch on the other leg. One more breath. And release. And come back to your back. Take a moment here to feel that your knees rest against each other. Deeply inhale. And go, ha. One more of those. Deeply inhale. And then you can find your way back to a seated position to prepare for a meditation. So you can sit up on something or just be on the floor or come to a chair. And take a moment to, again, tune in. Back to check in to how you feel, like we checked before. So with your eyes closed, take a deep breath in again. And let it out. And come back to noticing. And once more, first of all, ask yourself, how do I know I have a body with my eyes closed? Is it because you feel sensations? And what kind of sensations do you feel? Is it subtle? Is it strong? And what does it tell you about yourself? There's no right answer. These are just really nice questions to ask and see what sort of answers you get. And there may be a really big I have no idea, or insecurity, or you may come into a place of not knowing, and that is perfect. Don't try and figure it out. Just ask the question and see what happens. Who is it that sits here? There's obviously something. And if you fill in I am, in my case Esther, if you fill in your name, what does that experience point to? What do you feel when you say, I am, fill it in, I'm Esther? To what experience does that point to? So don't fill it in with the mind, but feel it with the body, the answer. And this is, interestingly enough, we will all more or less feel the same thing. And this is also, again, where we can connect with each other. What you feel is a presence, what you feel is an aliveness, is a beingness that has nothing to do, not much to do with comes up, with what comes after, with who this feels. It's just that aliveness, and that aliveness, that beingness points to your true nature, to everybody's true nature, which is the same. One energy, one true nature. We are all connected within what you're feeling right now, that beingness, that aliveness, that sense of presence. Literally the felt sense of being here. Just imagine all of us again, tuning in to all of us meditating together on that feeling of beingness. And relax your jaw. And relax your belly. And allow yourself to just settle into this without having to figure it out with the mind. And from your heart, bring your attention to your heart center. Tune into the stillness around you. And into the stillness within, which is the same stillness. And feel how that subtle sense of presence has no boundary of the skin. It moves beyond the skin very easily. It has nothing to do with the physical body, well, to a degree. But it doesn't stop with the physical body. It's much bigger. Physical body is merely a part of who you are, as is the mind, as are your feelings and your emotions and your sensations. So, who are you beyond all that? I'd like you to, from the heart, with real a lot of kindness, with a lot of love, feel into your whole body, into the physical body, the head, the neck, the shoulders, the arms, the hands, the chest and upper back, mid-back, and mid-stomach, sort of lower back, lower belly, hips, and both legs. And with kindness, observe, notice. Again, observe the physical sensation of you, the felt sense of you. You can gently and quietly say to yourself, I see you and I love you. I see how hard you work to be happy, to be healthy, to do the right thing. It might not always work out, but that's not the point. You're trying. I see you. And I love you. Your spiritual practice, your spiritual insights, your spiritual life begins with self-compassion, with kindness, because kindness brings you into that green zone, into that autonomic state in which you are relaxed and at ease and feel safe, and from which change is possible, growth and healing and learning. And self-compassion and self-kindness takes you there, and self, you're not being nice to yourself. The opposite of self-kindness takes you away from it and brings you into the red or the blue zone, and there's no learning there, and no growth, and no healing. For all of that, we need to come back into that rest and digest state. So learn to recognize where you are, and do what you need to do to bring yourself back into that green zone, where you feel connected and at ease and safe and present. And use self-compassion to do that where necessary. And know that in that green zone, change happens, because everything inside of you wants to be brought back to balance and brought back to a place in which growth is possible. So it's not all that complicated. It starts with awareness, with mindfulness and kindness. So, from your heart, from my heart to your hearts, may you all be happy. May you all find your way back to that relaxed place, that safe place, that autonomic state in which you feel relaxed and present. And that all your actions that you undertake to be happy also bear fruit, because you're in the right place. And may all beings everywhere find happiness and peace and find a way out of suffering. And may this practice be of benefit to all beings. Bring the palms together in front of the heart space. And let's imagine that we all bow to each other's hearts, to those beautiful hearts that just want to be loved and wants to be seen and wants to be happy, all of those hearts. So inhale and exhale. And come back. Okay. So you can open your eyes when you're ready. And I hope that that made sense, and that you're beginning to learn how to be self-sufficient, what you need to do to get to that place in which everything you do makes sense and has an effect, because you are in that state of being in which there's fertile ground. So, yes. So I'd like to tell you as well that I am teaching a live day retreat online. the 12th of December, Saturday. And there is a link, I hope, in the description underneath this video. I think my husband just put it in. And I'd love you to join me. So it'll be on YouTube like this, but I'll also have time to actually, in the breaks, comment, and you can ask questions and chat amongst each other. It's an unlisted link, so it's just for the group that signs up. And you can have a look. And I would love it if many of you would join me on that day. And the day will be just so helpful to really find that relaxation, because in the end, it's the deep relaxation that makes your view of the world change. So then the world doesn't need to change anymore, because you have changed yourself from the inside. So please join me for that. And thank you so, so, so much for being here today with me again. Namaste. I'm just looking at your comments. Thank you, everyone. So many names that I begin to recognize and know. And oh, there's a link in the chat here now as well to my relax and, it's not retrieve, but recharge, but it doesn't matter, my relax and recharge retreat. and in the description, there's another link. So, oh, Joycelyn, you have the same shirt. Yeah, it's great, isn't it? Okay. All right. Okay. All these lovely people. See you. I think I'm back Monday. So I'll see you Monday already. Bye. I'm going to end the stream now.